Hey guys, how's it going? Now when it comes to capturing a long web page, just taking a normal screenshot, well, just does not cut it because that will only capture a selected portion, but you need to capture the entire page, right? Which is why Apple's macOS now comes with a native built-in functionality for taking scrolling screenshots. With that being said, a lot of guys actually prefer using third-party tools that, well, make the whole process easier and also better for editing those scrolling screenshots. So what are those ways? How do you take a native screenshot and what are the best apps that you can use on your macOS device to take scrolling screenshots? Well, that's what this video is all about. This is Varun from Guiding Tech and let's get started. So starting with the macOS 10.14 Mojave update, Apple has introduced a native way of capturing scrolling screenshots. Here's how you can do that. To initiate a scrolling screenshot, you need to hit the Shift plus Command plus 5 keyboard shortcut to launch the on-screen capture controls. You can now hover the mouse pointer over each option to know what it is. However, I feel that using this tool to capture the entire screen is a little tedious. The keyboard shortcut, that is Shift plus Command plus 3, also takes a snapshot of the entire screen. Alright, so while that was a native way, let's talk about some third-party apps that let you take a scrolling screenshot in a much better way. And the go-to recommendation in that scenario has to literally be Snagit. Now, Snagit is a popular choice for Windows users, but it's my go-to choice for macOS as well. From recording videos of screen activities to capturing screenshots, the Grab tool lets you click a scrolling screenshot with a simple keystroke. Now, apart from that, Snagit allows you to highlight or visually annotate a few parts of the screenshots. The smart window detection will let you crop out any unwanted window borders, especially the ones that reveal some information. My only gripe is that Snagit makes use of its editor to finalize the image, but it does make up for that by letting me drag and drop those screenshots in messenger apps, emails, and other applications. Now, one thing to note here is that Snagit comes with a hefty price tag of $49.95. The 15-day trial is an excellent way to take it for a spin though. Now, of course, that's a very premium price tag, and I'm not saying that it's not justified, but a lot of you guys might prefer free alternatives for that. And well, what better than a browser extension? Except that BrowShot is not a browser extension, but an app in itself. So like many other tools, BrowShot has one marquee feature. It lets you capture scrolling screenshots in the PNG format. Now, that's quite useful for anyone seeking to store a lot of details without compromising on the quality and does not mind the heftier file size. Additionally, it also provides you with an option to reset the cookies and cache data, so you don't have to store those files on your computer. Now, that's smart. Moving along, we have Gyazo, which is another tool that lets you easily take scrolling screenshots on your macOS device. Now, Gyazo is a cross-platform tool for taking full-scale screenshots by pressing the defined hotkeys. Unfortunately, the macOS users will have to install the Gyazo Chrome or Firefox extension to assign shortcuts for quick captures. Now, that's a small inconvenience to capture scrolling screenshots. You can have the Gyazo app running on the dock to sweep into the action quickly. The only part that I find annoying is that it opens up another tab to open the captured image with a temporary link and an editor. Now, if you're a Firefox user, things are going to be helpful for you because Firefox in itself comes with a native screenshot option built inside to the browser. Yup, when you click on the three dot buttons next to the address bar, the context menu shows you the take a screenshot option at the bottom. The Firefox screenshot is the most convenient option on this list, doesn't cost anything and lets you take a screenshot as well. The only thing to note here is that yes, you will have to download a different browser, so there's that. Now, like I said, you will have to download a different browser, but what if you are just too much into the Safari system? Well, don't worry, there's a way out for taking full screen scrolling screenshots with Safari as well, although that's a bit of a tedious process. Let me show you how it's done. So the first thing that you need to do is open Safari and navigate to the web page that you need to take a screenshot for. If a reader view is available, click on that because obviously the screenshot will look better here, but that's totally your call. If you do not want to use it, then don't click it. Now on the menu bar, select File, then click on Export as PDF. Select a location and then save the PDF there. Once that's done, open the PDF file in preview, then select File, Export, and set the format to either JPEG or PNG and save. And that's it. And well, that was it. As always, you can find the download links to all of the apps that I talked about down in the description box. Also, if you found this video helpful, make sure to let us know by giving us a thumbs up and subscribing to our channel for more awesome tech content. Till then, this is Varun from Guiding Tech, and I'll see you in the next one.